This is like a situation where, like, if we were talking about the container we used as an example, what would this equation describe about that container? Maybe face forward and listen. Jackson?
It's higher.
Gets higher every second.
Two inches.
Sure. Like, I mean, we could make this represent any situation, but in this situation with the container filling with water, 2 inches higher every second is what this is saying. This is our rate, right? We need to call it 2 inches every second. Do you need to stand between them so you won't talk? Okay. 2 inches per second is what we could call that. What about this? What's this plus one mean? Yeah.
Does it mean where you have started already at one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So whether we think of this guy is like having a little stand that makes it higher off of the ground, we could even think of it as it already had some water before we started filling it up. Does that make sense? Just started with some water in it, right? So it started at 1 inch tall, and then 2 inches for every second, okay? Or we could think of it as we started with $1. We already have $1, and then this means that we're earning $2 every 1 hour, even though that's not a very good way to pay, but it completely makes sense, right, what the numbers mean. So, what's that?
Could be 2 cents every 1 second.
2 cents a second, I think. That'd be even worse than $2 every hour.
Yeah, there each year. 2 cents a second, that's too good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Every 100 seconds.
So when we look for the graph that we're supposed to match it with, because it's a matching situation, we're looking for the graph where it starts at 1, whatever that 1 represents. It can represent dollars, can represent inches, whatever it represents, right? That's the point, 0, 1. Okay. Even more on why there's a point right there. We've done this before where we plug in 0 for x, right, and y equals 1. That tells us 0 for x gives us 1 for y. All right, so starting point, y-intercept, if I put in 0 for x, I get 1, right? All those things, different ways of knowing that there's a point on the y-axis at 1. Okay. Then, how many seconds go by?
1 second
goes by, and what happens in that 1 second?
Another two inches
are added on. Right. And there we go. In 1 more second, we're going to have a total of 3 inches of water. In 1 more hour, we're going to have a total of $3, whatever this equation might represent. Okay. We follow that slope of to the right 1 and up 2. To the right 1 and up 2. And that's what our graph should look like. If we look at our choices, A is out, C is certainly out, it has a negative slope. B has exactly this graph, so B. If you're not taking notes, well, I'm not going to be surprised if you don't catch on to this and you don't quite clear up confusions you may have had, especially if you didn't do your homework at all. 1/5 x + 3. Okay. Same idea, right? Same basic idea. This guy right here is our rate, okay? If we're talking about the container filling with water, what is this telling me about that container filling with water?
That's how much it fills 1/5 every hour.
If we were going to use those, the example we were talking about yesterday, right?
Maybe 1 second.
What's that?
Maybe 1 second.
1 second?
One inch for every hour.
1/5 of an inch every second, yes? Or?
A foot every 5
we're using inches, but that's certainly, I remember we were saying inches and not feet yesterday.
Yeah.
But
oh,
yeah.
1 inches.
Yeah, like one, whatever, one vertical distance unit for every 5 seconds. Okay. So if this is time, this is distance, well, then this relates to the distance and this relates to the time. Remember from our first exposure to graphing these, we want to put in an x that is what?
Zero.
Zero is good to start with. Okay, so that tells us that we start at 3, right? We put in 0, we get 3. Right. We're starting to catch on to this pattern that every time I see a plus 3, I'm going to see a point on the y-axis at 3, because I can just kind of put the 0 in with my brain. I don't really have to think about it that hard. Right. Then I'm going to go over how much?
5,
right? Just 5 seconds later, what's going to happen?
It's going to go up 1.
It's going to go up 1 inch from there. 5 seconds later, it's going to go up 1 inch. There's the line. You can just draw a line between those 2 points. We happen to know that it's going to be a line. In the future, not all graphs are going to be lines, but for now,
that's
they are, which is nice. If you find 2 points, you can connect them to that line. Okay. So remember that rate tells us the slope of the line. Remember how we talked about in the real world, that number right there is the rate of change, the inches per second, right? 1 inch per 5 seconds. In the line, it's not really called the rate, it's called the
slope.
The slope, right? But if I know the slope, I know the rate. If I know the rate, I know the slope. If I were to just look at this graph, I could tell that every 5 seconds go by, we add 1 inch. So the slope is 1/5, the rate is 1/5. Which, just to bring up what Tiana said, that could mean 1 inch per 5 seconds or 1/5 of 1 inch every 1 second.
How?
Which makes sense, right? Because 1/5 the first second, 1/5 the second second, 1/5 the third second, 1/5 the fourth second, 1/5 the fifth second, that's a total of 1 now. We've added up 5 bits. All right, so over 5. And up 1, for 5, the right 5, and up 1, and 24. Apple. Okay. So, admission to an apple orchard costs $5, and to buy apples, you pick your own apples, but then you still pay 75 cents a pound. Okay. So this would be, what do we call that when we hear the word per, Robert?
Rate.
Your rate. You have a rate of change, right? The cost changes as the weight changes. Pounds go up, the price goes up. Okay. So if we were going to write this equation that describes how much it's going to cost after buying X pounds of apples, Robert?
It would be 0.75x5.
Well, what do we think about that? Does that make sense? Sarah?
Yeah.
Never mind. How about if we buy, like, we show up, here we are, we walk up to this farmhouse, which we're way too big to fit inside. You know, behind the farmhouse, through this gate, there's all these apple trees. Okay?
Great job.
Now, how much is it going to cost us to get to that side of the fence?
$5.
$5. Do we have any apples so far?
No.
If we have 0 apples, how much does it cost us?
$5.
Okay, let's see if that works with our equation. Y equals 0.75 times 0 pounds of apples plus 5. Is that true?
Yeah.
0 pounds of apples, still $5, starts at $5. If we buy 1 pound, right, we get in, we pay $5, we get 1 pound, we're going to pay how much for that 1 pound?
75 cents.
Every time we buy a pound, our price goes up 75 cents. Let's look at it. What's the 0.75 as a fraction?
Three fourths.
So we can look at that as 3/4 of a dollar per pound, or we can look at it as $3 per
four
pounds of apples. Yeah. So if we want to get it, like, we don't have any change in our pocket, we're going to pay whole numbers of dollars. How many pounds should we buy?
Four
pounds. Right. 4 pounds, and then our cost goes up how much?
It's $3.
Goes up $3. Right. If we were looking at graph of this, get rid of this guy here, now we get the idea. Look at a graph. If we're buying 0 pounds of apples, we're still going to pay how much?
$5.
$5. So we're going to go up to $5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. Then I pick some apples. I pick 4 pounds of apples. Once I pick 4 pounds of apples, how much does my price go up?
$3.
$3 whole dollars. 4 pounds of apples, $3. Now, I could have gone over 1 pound. Gone over 1 pound. Every time I get 1 pound, how much does my cost go up?
75 cents.
75 cents. So, like, right about there. But that's all on the same line, right? Follows that same line right up to that other point. It's over 4 and up 3. I could keep going up 75 cents for every 1 pound, and I'd get the exact same place. Exact same ratio. And there we go. That line catches all those points. And I guess we could draw this part of the line, but what would this part of the line represent?
Low.
Like, I mean, the part of the line that is in this region.
Negative.
Negative what?
Negative apples.
Negative apples, negative pounds of apples, right? You have to, maybe we give them apples?
Or maybe you drop apples, so you have to pay them for the apples. But
we already had to pay for apples.
Maybe you steal the apples.
Steal the apples.
Maybe you destroy them, and then you have to pay for those apples.
We have to pay for them whether we destroy them or eat them or
you
pick them, take them home, whatever you do to them, you still pay for them. Lose apples?
Yeah.
I think negative apples, if positive apples is the apples that I get, then negative apples, yeah, would be apples that I lose, so I would have to somehow bring apples
you eat.
The to
horse the
situation.
Stole.
That's
apple
an apple I get.
An apple you
that's my apple,
you
I ate it.
Yeah, what if you? They don't know you ate it?
No, I guess we're going to steal
you
the
dropped
situation.
It and you ruined it. So you
that's what I
it.
Said.
But it's still, like, if I dropped it and ruined it, it'd be the same as if I didn't drop it and I took
okay,
it.
Okay, just eat it in the
orchard.
I don't know.
In
an
orchard?
Yeah, and
you
like, ate
it in the
orchard without paying for it.
Fresh.
Okay, this is all very dishonest, but I think negative pounds, I think Jackson's right, it has to be apples that we lose, not apples that we gain. Whether I eat it or I take it home, I gained it, right? It's mine now. It's in my belly. If they go backwards, that must mean that I brought apples from somewhere else. I already had them. I brought them and gave them to them. But then, like, they buy them.
But you're losing money.
Or, like, someone stole
them. No, we're
them
losing from. Cost.
They steal your apples.
This positive slope is telling us how much we have to pay.
Yeah.
Which is actually money we lose.
Right.
Yeah.
So if our the amount we pay goes down, the amount it goes down, then we start to actually get money back.
Yeah. Okay, I got it.
You got it.
Buy the apples, and then someone steals them from you. So you're losing apples. So you're losing money.
Yeah, well, you're losing money when you move this direction because you're buying apples, right? And you're paying money.
Yep.
You're already losing money. But you're gaining apples. It's okay.
I'm confused.
Maybe you take your apples, you pretend like you didn't buy them, and then you go up to them and say, hey, I've got better apples than yours.
And they'll say, well, you just paid me $5 to come in here, and all of a sudden you have apples. I wonder where this came from. Know that you picked them.
Well, no. You can leave, and then you can come back.
Isn't the answer dishonest? Just bring them apples.
Well, or like
your cost goes down.
Like if you left them out, like if you went home and you had horses, and like you put them.
Horses are coming in this situation.
Well, you know what?
That could happen. You could have them in a bag,
and then
horses
like,
come and eat them.
Because that's what happened to me one time when we went to my friend's.
Interesting.
And
Okay.
They don't eat the bag. They're not stupid.
One more thing. Or something like, I wanted you to bring this up. Like, y equals negative 8/3 x plus 9.
Bring another example. This is actually number 20.
I don't need to get like off track, but I have a question for you.
Okay, well, if you don't need to get off track, then don't ask me this question.
But it's actually pretty important. Well, you know how you're like always like, oh, on Friday, if we have more extra than Dextra, we get to do something fun.
I said that if we have more extra than Dextra, then something good happens.
Yeah, well, what?
Something
one
good
happens. One particular
right
week,
now.
But that was what it was, and this week it might not happen. Not doing very well. So let's just keep going. Right. I have plans. So this equation, if we were to relate it to that example that we've been using, we start out with what?
9 inches.
So like we just have 9 inches. Whether the glass is up off the table or we already just have 9 inches of water starting out. Okay. What happens after that? Every
-8 seconds. Oh wait, no, it's 3.
Oh.
You get negative. You take out.
Ah. So every 3 seconds we take out 8 inches. Okay. So it starts out with 9 inches, call it 9. Then 3 seconds later, what happens?
You take out 8 inches.
Lose 8 inches, whether there's a hole in it, or spilling out, or
drink
the holes,
drink
you drink it, whatever. It comes down to here, because it drops down 8 inches, right? So we go to the right three, to the right three, to the right three, to the right three, and we go down 8. We go down 8 inches, right?
Okay.
Then we go up.
We go up
this much. But how much is this much?
Negative.
Right? Going up in a negative amount is actually going down. Going up in a negative way is actually going down. All right. So, once again, I'm going to say this is the 10th or 11th time. Here we have the start, right? That's where we start. And here we have our rate. Okay. And as we look at the rate on the graph, it translates to the slope of the graph. The slope is I go to the right 3 and down 8. To the right 3 and down 8. Now, let me just talk to you for a second. I'm the kind of student who showed up, didn't look to my left, and talked to someone over there, paid attention and took notes, participated, okay, went home and did the homework, or at least tried really hard to do the homework, even if it was confusing. Tried to do the homework the best that I could, came in, saw that I got a few wrong, asked some questions, again took some notes just now as we talked about this. Okay. Be pretty adept at graphing a line given this kind of an equation. That's all I'm asking you to do. I'm asking you, if I give you an equation like this, written in this way, there's lots of ways to write equations of lines. This is only one of them, and that's all we've been concentrating on. Okay? This is the slope, and this is what we call the y-intercept. Okay? It's where it crosses the y-axis, right? But we can see that because the y-axis, right, is right in the middle. Not over here, not to the left, not to the right, but in the middle where x is equal to what?
The slope.
No. Y-intercept. We're talking about being on the y-axis. Okay. Y-intercept is on the y-axis. On the y-axis, what is x equal to?
Zero.
There are others. We're not over here where x is positive. We're not over here where x is negative. We're right in the middle where x is, there's like no x. It's just zero. And if x were zero, then this is the only thing that'd be left
to be what y is equal to,
right? Y equals anything times 0 plus b. B.
Whatever b is, we'll have a point on the y-axis at b. We don't have to look at variables. We can talk about it in real numbers. There's an example 9, right? If I plug in a 0 for x, I'll get 9 for y. 0, 9.
There it is right there. 0, 9.
So where we start. It's how many inches of water we start with. It's how many dollars we start with. It's how many dollars it costs to get into the apple orchard. It's it could be admission. It could be any amount that is like our initial amount that we start with. Or at least it could be thought of that. At 0 seconds, we have 9. 0 hours, we have $9. 0 of x, we have 9 of y. And as we increase x by 3, y decreases by 8. Because if I were to plug a 3 in for x, the 3 would divide that 3 and be left just with negative 8 divided by 1. Carter, that's helping you?
Hmm?
Is that helping you?
This?
No. Miming licking at somebody else. I don't know. Is it helping you?
No.
Let's stop doing it. Okay. All right. So I want you to be able to graph an equation like that with the slope and the y-intercept. Right? This thing tells me where I start on the y-axis. Right? It's not really magic. I just know that if I plug in 0 for x, that's where I'm going to start. Can plug things in for x, and that's great, and that's what you do, keep doing it. But also, we can shortcut that a little bit by saying, well, if I were to start at 0, x is 0, then what y value would I get?
Can we get negative 2?
Can we get negative 2? So let's just start out there. Did I have to do any math? Did I have
to try it?
I have to write a table? I have to plug it in and write down my work and show all my work? Did any of that have to happen?
No.
Because it's getting to the point where we've done it so many times, we know. Right? We're going to start down at on the y-axis at negative 2. That's clear. Okay? Then, right, we're going to move to the right, and then we're going to move up or down depending on what makes sense, right?
Uh-huh.
So we're going to move to the right how much?
3.
Why 3?
Because it says
3. Well, we got the denominator of 3. Here's a reminder of why this is, like why we're using the shortcut. We're going to move to the right 3, right? What axis is this on that I'm moving to the right on? The x-axis, right? X is 3. Remember how we want x to be 3, right? Yeah. So we want to move over 3 because 3 will be a value of x that we cancel the denominator. And when we move over 3, how much are we going to move up?
5,
right? Every 3 seconds, 5 inches are added on. Every 3 seconds, 5 more inches. 3 more seconds, 5 more inches. So we move to the right 3. We move up 1, 2. 3, 4, 5.
Oh, I'm a winner.
Now, careful not, it doesn't move up to 5, like up to the number 5, or up to 5 in the y direction. It moves up 5 from the previous point.
So it goes up 5 hash marks?
No. Yeah, 5 hash marks.
Okay.
It sounded like half marks. You didn't say half.
Hash marks.
Zach?
I did it a different way, but still got the same answer.
What'd you do?
Like I did. Y was 5, positive 5, and x was 3, and then I just subtracted 2 from the y.
Y was what now?
5. Like the y-axis, it was 5 up.
Y was 5.
Then I subtracted 2 from 5 and got 3 over.
And then went over there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do that. Did you get this point here too?
Oh no, I got it.
Okay. Well, that one. You really just need any 2 points, right? But this is like the fastest way of all the mathematicians and all of history that said, hey, if it's written like this, here's your fastest way to get 2 points. You can see that you're going to have a point at negative 2 on the y-axis
see that you're going to have to move to the right 3, right? Because you want to cancel the 3. So plug in a 3. We move to the right 3. What happens when you move to the right 3? Well, 5 more whatevers are added on. 3 seconds later, 5 inches added on. 3 more seconds, 5 more inches. 3 more seconds, 5 more inches. Okay, so let's put everything away. Okay. So, we need 2 points to graph this line. You can see immediately, Brandon, that.
You can
plug in 0, and that immediately gives me a y of -2. Just right there, right in front of my face, so obvious. 0 in for x gives me -2 for y, right? Real speedy. And we're going to use the slope, right? The slope isn't over, right? Over the right or left, but I usually go to the right, because it's a lot of times x is time, and we think of time as going forward, right? So as time goes forward, right, as we move to the right, are we going to move up or are we going to move down? We move down. We're going to every so many, let's say, seconds, we're going to lose some inches, right? How many seconds are going to go by? We're going to go to the right, how much?
5.
We're going to go to the right 5, right? Not 3. Now, that's a common mistake. But let me remind you, or help you remind yourself why it's to the right 5. The right, that's an x, right? We're going in the x direction. We want to go to the right 5, because look at what's going to happen here. When we go to the right, we're really going to the next x value that's convenient. The next convenient x value is not 3, but 5, right? We want to go to the right 5, so that 5 will divide 5. So we go to the right 5, and we're going to lose 3 inches to the right 5 and down 3. There we are, losing 3 inches. Yes, Sarah?
So I did mine on like the opposite side because it's a negative.
That is also a common thing. You go back 5 and back down 3.
Yeah. That's
but that, if you think about it, is the same as going to the right 5 and up 3. That would make the same line, right? Mm-hmm. You can go to the left, but as you go to the left, you would go up instead, right?
Yeah.
So if I go to the left 5 and down 3, look at that. A negative divided by a negative is a positive. It's the same as having a positive slope. One of them needs to be negative, it's a negative slope. So forward, that's positive, and down, that's negative. Or left, that's negative, and up, that's positive. Okay? And anything that's a negative slope should go down as we look at it to the right. Right? We should lose as we go forward. All right. Have a good weekend, everybody. Look forward to seeing you next week.